Oh, Pat is down on the pitch side. Oh, is he is down there. Pat.
Well, if it wasn't hard enough dealing with the pressure of the playoff environment, they've got the West Country weather to deal with as well. It's wet out there, it's very slippy. There's a gale blowing down the pitch, and it's going to really make it difficult for these two sides that love to play rugby really to get things going. He's going to take a cool head in the middle, and the man in charge of that is Tim Wigglesworth, and helping him for any tricky decisions back in the truck, Graham Hughes. It's going to be a cracking game.
After 138 games, just six to go, we are down to the final four. Who can take that first step towards the Premiership? This is the first leg of the first semi-final of this season's Greene King IPA Championship. It's Bristol against Rotherham, and it's Slovic who takes it up initially for Bristol.
Advantage over
to Puna and Redkins. Nice try scorer in Championship history. Trainer,
you put yourself in front, you run the risk.
All that territory in position. Now Rotherham have the penalty, and surely Juan Pablo Socino will step up and go for 3 points, surely.
Thank you.
Yep. Well, that's what he's done all season, so he's going to do that. It was a tremendous, tremendous turnover from Jack Priest down there. And again, the first time you've seen them not running it out, putting the boot to the ball, they made 40 metres, turned the ball over again, you've got a chance of 3 points. This would be a tremendous fillip and lift for Rotherham if this goes over. 97% against the wind, that is.
Incredible, absolutely incredible territory from Bristol, and that gamble, we're calling it a gamble. Andy Robinson didn't call it a gamble to Pat in the pre-match interview, didn't he? But that gamble has not worked out for Bristol. Socino, huge amount of points this season, not just the Championship but any league. A very, very good kicker. And it's right through the uprights. Juan Pablo Socino puts Rotherham into the lead, and who would believe it?
And if you want to see just how invested this Rotherham squad are, the Bristol squad have all sat down on their bench, very calm and collected. All the Rotherham boys up on their feet, on the edge of the technical area, cheering their team on. It means the world to them.
Well, you mentioned it there, Pat, edge, and I think there has been an edge, talking to Lee Blackett before Sanderson got injured this week by a training accident out there. Everyone was putting it in. Obviously some players a little bit peeved that they're not in the 22, and that's good to see from the Yorkshire side. And that was a great kick from Socino, 40 minutes down under all that pressure, and to come 3 points up, that's what they've got to do. Stay in the game, make it into the 20 minutes sort of quarters, and then just build it from there.
Fantastic atmosphere down here, but it's piling the pressure on Bristol
from the back.
Crow wants to take it quickly. Wigglesworth says come back and take it from the mark.
Socino will have another go of this. I'm sure he's got the distance with the wind behind him. Mulcrane brought back there. It is the right thing to do. It's the thing that he does all the time. But unfortunately, you've got to take it from the mark. And it wasn't from the mark, but the clock will tick down. He'll take his time. You know, has to be from the mark. It's not. Well, you've seen them given, haven't you?
Poor man.
Where is the mark? I don't know. From the back or from where the referee's standing? Has to be from the back. But again, clock ticking down. This is what Blackett and the boys will be happy with. And especially happy if this goes over. That will be 6-0.
He's an important man, isn't he? Tim Wigglesworth today. A bit of column inches, a bit of publicity around him in that Bar Gloucester game. Two red cards, five yellows in that game. Socino. Does it have the legs? It certainly does. What a kick from Socino. Bristol 0, Rotherham 6. Great deal of money that's been spent on this Bristol squad, not only this season, but looking at next season as well. Ryan Jones, Frank Teal, Chris Brooker, Max Crofton, Aaron Hudson, Jack O'Connell, Greg Hampson, Ollie Robinson, Jack Lamb, the Hurricanes flanker as well. Massive investment, and with that comes massive pressure. And at the moment, Bristol are not dealing with that pressure, and it's Rotherham who have nothing to lose. As Socino lines up this kick, we can have a quick chat with player coach Ed Williamson. Ed, can you quite believe the start that your side is making?
Well, I can, yeah, because what we've been working on for the last 2 weeks is exactly what the boys have been doing. We just set out that this first 20 is so hugely important to us defensively, and that's where the area of concern has been for us, so we've put everything we possibly can into it, and the boys are getting a bit of reward from it now.
And where does the heart desire come to make those tackles when 97% territory against you in that opening 10 minutes?
Well, it just, I think you've already said it. I heard you say it just before you came on here with me, is that we've got nothing to lose. So what's the point in holding back? The boys know it. I've pumped into them the last, as I said, 2 weeks. Just every contact, every collision you've got in front of you, just smash into it. Ed, do as much as you can.
Ed, it's Dewey. Are you going to get out there in the second half? I know you've got a broken bone in your hand, but nothing too serious.
Nothing, just a little nothing. I'm putting my eyeballs and painkillers anyway, so it doesn't matter. Hopefully I'll get a run out for you, and then we'll see what I can do.
Good on you, pal.
Cheers, mate.
Ready, can't wait to get out there. Spoke to Lee Blackett. He said he just needs to have some man-up pills.
From a winger to a forward.
Yeah.
Man-up pills. That's what you need to do.
Rotherham have the ball. There's the whistle. There will be no further action in this first half as Bristol go in. And would you believe this fairy tale season for Rotherham continues in the first leg of this semi-final. 9-0 the score to the visitors.
Well, they've batted well above their weight all season. Can they actually believe it? Well, they can in a sense, because they're a good outfit. They're a well-coached outfit. They've sorted themselves out, and 9-0 is just a fairy tale, but it's a big 40 minutes to go.
Unbelievable 40 minutes to go. Let's hear from Charlie Mulcrow now, who's with Pat.
Charlie, you must be pleased with the effort that your pack have put in that first half.
Yeah, it was a big first 40 with the win, but we defended quite well, especially in our own third, so pleased with that.
Now, big win second half. Big job for you in particular to keep this pack moving forward.
Yeah, I think it's just important we look after the ball. So if we turn it over, we probably won't see it for a while. So just hold on to it and just play with tempo like we do.
Great first half, well done.
Well, these Championship playoffs have offered up some extraordinary storylines over the years, but are we seeing the most unlikely of them all? Rotherham lead Bristol, the powerhouse of Bristol, by 9-0 at half-time. Fine margins, a few errors, a fair few nerves and a whole load of tension. But we have got one almighty upset on our hands in the first of this season's Greene King IPA Championship semi-finals. 9-0 for the visitors.
And that is going to be key, isn't it? The fitness in this second half. The conditions have changed here. The wind really picked up. There's a squall of heavy rain. The blue sky has come back over. But this wind, this strong wind behind Bristol in this second half, who trail by 9 points to Juan Pablo Socino and his Rotherham side. At the Memorial Stadium, will the tactics change? Well, they'll have to, won't they? For Rotherham, who took those long-range kicks from halfway. Two of them right on the halfway line from some short, sharp, concise move to the pocket from Tim Wigglesworth.
Hang on a minute. First things first, don't get involved, OK? That's it for you. You, however.
Don't think there can be an argument there, Derry.
No, there isn't an argument, because the intent was there. I think actually Thomas Brown said that he can't be a red, and it isn't a red, and it's a yellow, which is the right decision. So if it was going to be hard work for Rotherham, with 9-0 up with this wind, it's got even harder now, down to 14 guys. Crucial guy in the line-out, crucial guy in the scrum. Obviously, they're under so much pressure in the scrum as it is. This is now Bristol's turn to get back in this game.
Down to 14 men then. Ben Clynn right at the top of his jump. It's a brilliant throw from Reece Lawrence. It's a brilliant line-out take from Ben Glynn, and here come Bristol. Advantage already coming to the men in blue. They are pile driving their way to this line now, Bristol. Unhappy with that first half scoreline. Cortez, he wriggles over, does he? And Bristol
nice and steady. Nice
do have their try. Finally, the gavel pays off. The power from the driving ball from the line out. We have seen it all season long from Andy Robinson. It's Preecy, played hooker last week, seven this week. He's playing scrum half there.
Reader is absolutely everywhere. If that ball had gone to the right, there was an opportunity, but another turnover.
It has been turnover. Now there's space for Bristol. Marco Mama, Slovic, step from Slovic. Here come Bristol. What a tackle from Jamie Broadley. He's just done enough to bring down Slovic, but it's still Bristol on the attack. Reece Lawrence, great hands, and it's Bristol again. It's Luke Eaves. What a sensational breakout from Bristol.
Big moment of the game.
They have had some edgy times, this club. A few years ago against the Pirates. Exeter a few years before that. But here goes Edie. He scored!
Disagrees, allowed to press the ball.
They have peppered the Rotherham line for the last 10 minutes, Bristol. And finally, finally they come out with a 5-point. Nolan Davis. A charge to kick down Robinson. Every point matters now, doesn't it? It really does. 0 from 3 so far today. Doesn't miss that one. Does not miss that one. 17-9 now.
I think with the win, Reader is absolutely out on his feet now. He's picked up a knock. He's got cramp. Again, it's all hands to the pump for Bristol to defend this. But again, Rotherham just show why they're such a good side. Their fitness is outstanding.
Davis kicks it forward. Watkins is there. Broadley's there too. Has he scored?
Time off.
What a massive moment in this semi-final. This is
try yes or no, okay.
We're going to the television match official. What has just happened there?
Try yes or no, that's what's been asked.
Is it a Clement Poitrineau moment?
I don't think it's as bad as or embarrassing as that. That is a try from Jamie Broadley, as long as he was on the side, which I think he was, by a country mile.
And he didn't touch anybody.
Tim,
yeah.
You may have worked a try.
Thank you.
It has been given. It didn't take Graham Hughes long, did it?
30 seconds.
30 seconds left in this game. And Rotherham, again, play their fitness card. 3 points the difference. The conversion still to come from the league's leading point scorer.
It is, but he can take a minute to do this. He will go for it. It's a hard, hard kick. You'll have to swing this in. You have to aim at the right-hand post to bring it in. And he'll give it absolutely everything.
One of the strangest kicks of the season. But there it is. Socino has missed. But it is only 3 points the difference. They wanted it in single figures, didn't they, Rotherham, to take back home next week. But importantly, Darren, we should say this, Bristol have won this game. All they need to do next week, and I say all they need to do, is go up to Sheffield and win again.
And they're capable of that. Who was their 23rd man today? Didn't play Ryan Jones. That's the calibre they can bring on if they need to. I don't think they need to panic. They just need to be a bit more clinical. Stop doing these kicking into the corner and gambling your points away. 3 points.